page number 18, 8th example, subset relation between the sets, subset relation between the sets. Subset relations between the sets. Here X is a set of all quadrilaterals, Y is a set of all rhombus, S is a set of all squares, T is a set of all parallelograms, and V is a set of all rectangles. So, rough count. First of all, parallelogram. Parallelogram. Then the rectangle that is V, then rhombus that is Y, then square that is S, and X is the set of all quadrilaterals. In parallelogram, there are 5 properties. Rectangle, there are 6 properties. Rhombus, there are 6 properties. Square, there are 7 properties. And this one is all quadrilaterals. So, subset relations between the sets. Number 1 is T is a subset of V. T is subset of V. Second one, again T is a subset of Y. Again T is a subset of S. T is a subset of S. Number 4, T is a subset of all quadrilaterals means X. T is the subset of all quadrilaterals means X. Now the part of parallelogram is over. Now rectangle. Rectangle, 6 properties, 6 properties. So no. So rectangle is a square. Rectangle is all quadrilaterals, larger one is X. Then the part of rectangle is over. Then rhombus. So second is rhombus. Y is a subset. Rhombus is a square. Then A. Rhombus. All quadrilaterals. Then rhombus are there. Then part of rhombus is over. Then square. Square, all quadrilateral means square. This one is simple. So rough work is very important, because parallelogram has 5 properties, rectangle has 6 properties, rhombus had 6 properties, square had 7 properties, and all are the quadrilaterals. So the larger set is the all quadrilateral, that is X. Now, parallelogram is a rectangle. So T is a subset of T. Same thing, T is a subset of Y. Then same thing, T is a subset of S. And parallelogram is in all quadrilaterals. So T is a subset of X. Part of parallelogram is over. So rectangle is not rhombus. Rectangle is not a rhombus. So rectangle is a square. So V is a subset of S. V is a subset. that subset relations within the sets. Then universal set. Universal set. It is denoted by a capital U. If A, B, C are subsets of U, then U is universal set with respect to sets A, B, and C. You can write it as U is a set of all X where X belongs to A. U is a subset of all X where X belongs to A, X belongs to B, X is a part of C. Then U is called as a universal set. Means whatever the elements are there in A, whatever the elements are there in B, whatever the elements are there in C, all elements are found in the set U. So U is a universal set with respect to set A, B, and C. Then the complement. Then the complement. 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 A complement of the set. Let A be the subset of U, then the set of all elements in U but not in A is called as complement of A and is denoted by A dash. Hence, A dash is a set of all X where X belongs to U, but X is not part of A. X is not a part of A. Roughly say 1.3. Second example. Take the set of natural numbers from 1 to 20 as universal set. So universal set 1 to 20 means 1, 2, 3 up to 20. Now, X is a set of all X, where X is a natural number and select is less than X is less than 50. So it contains will have to show the x and y in Venn diagram. So we will have to first from 1 to 20. So universal set contains elements from 1 to 20, while x universal set contains elements 8 to 14. So x contains elements 8 to 14, and the remainder the elements are there, not in x but in u. So u contains all the 20 elements. Now second one is y is the state of all y, where y is natural number and y is prime number. From 1 to 20. So first prime number is 2, then 3, 5, 7, 9 is not 11. 13, 15 is not 17 and 19. Now first of all we have to write the set Y, Venn diagram Y. 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17 and 19. Now the U, universal set. One is not there, so out of the set Y, 2 is there, 3 is there, 4 is not there, 5 is there, 6, 7 is there, 8, 9, 10, 11 is there, 12, 13 is there, 14, 15, 16, 17 is there, so 8 is out of that, Y, 19 is there, so 20. So this one is the total universal set U, while X, Y is the set having the prime numbers from 1 to 20. So those prime numbers are 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19. So by the Venn diagram we have to show in such a way. Now third universal set 1, 2, 3, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and P is the set containing 1, 3, 7, 10 by Venn diagram first. So complement of P. 1 is not there, so 2. 3 is in P, so P will not be in P dash. So 7 is in P, so not in P dash. 8, 9. 10 is here, so 10 will not be in P dash. 11, 12. the P. So out of the P is 2, 8, 9, 11, and 12. So these 9 elements are there in the universal set, right? In the P, there are 4 elements. So this one is P. This one is P. Okay. Now, these examples you will have to study in home and try for those examples without seeing your copy.